We are privileged to discuss the Word of God again this morning. I'm James. I welcome all of you to this Bible classes, and it talks about mostly on our family life situations. Again, we are in this presence of God this morning. Let us give thanks to God and express our gratitude to God. Father in heaven, we love you this morning as we are in your presence once again. Bless each one of us as we are living in a time to glorify your name, Father. Bless all families also watching this program. Help them to enjoy it. Lord, fill us with your Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name I pray. Praise God for what we were discussing all these weeks about the total health of human life. So if we plan, it will happen. If we fail to plan, that's a plan to failure. That's what somebody says. So we need healing is one of our greatest call. We are thinking of healing only when we are sick. We don't have any pre-plan or early plan. We believe that we are healthy. It's good thoughts. We are healthy always. But all day you are deteriorating. Your age is passing, your health is coming down. These are the natural erosions are happening to the body of people, whoever you are. But whenever the erosion happen, deterioration happen, you will keep to supply what are the essential elements to your body. This is the same thing also is needed for our all part of body. We discuss about our spirit and we discuss about the mind, Pyushe, and we discuss the soma, the body. So we are in the part of God. We are the part of God. God created us in His own likeness and image. God has certain expectations from us. He appointed us and put us in a place where we are with the full capacity. But unfortunately, sin came to this world and damaged to our life. The damage happened body, soul and spirit. Because the first sin committed with the cooperation of these three things. So after that, human pain started. His age also limited. And his mind also in a confusion. And his spirit is struggling to establish a relationship with God. So we need to understand the process of creation and what happened to the creation, human creation through sin, and how has it connected with our present day life. As we discuss about the body, soul and spirit, the spirit of man is not fully functioned. The human spirit is in a dead level because it has cut off its relationship with God because of the sin. It's not committed by this body, but in that race made a mistake. So therefore, the body of people and the spirit of people should be reconnected with God. Where's the way? How to be reconnected with God? Not through our brain, not through our thinking pattern, but to our willful heart is needed. Because man choose to cut off the relation with God with his will. Same will is needed to get, receive God back to his life. Therefore, we ask everybody to receive Jesus as your personal Savior and Lord. I'm not talking about any religious connections. I'm talking about the spiritual connections. The man's spirit is incapable to receive the signals from the God. Even we have a big signal stations. They're sending the signals, but we need a good receiver to receive it. The human spirit's function is just like that. It has the reception capacity so that it will work out. So God actually justified our spirit through Jesus Christ, and the spirit of our have been justified. That means made right with God. Made right with God. That is justification. Our spirit is justified through Christ Jesus and his death on the cross, and his blood paid the penalty of the sin. So we realize that one. Then only we can re-establish our relationship with God. Justification. Justification. Justified. Made right with God. Our spirit justified. Now you have a justified spirit, means you have a right spirit. You have no need to carry any guilty conscience in your life. You paid the penalty to God, you penalty to the law. Don't worry about it. You are justified, declared free. Your spirit is free. No more bondages. No more worry. And also, your soul are being sanctified. That means made whole before God. Made holy before God. Your soul is holy because it can receive and it can detect and it can interpret things. It is made holy because of the Christ death on the cross. He is sanctified. This is what we call sanctification. Sanctification means declared as holy. Declared as holy. Justification. Justified as made right with God. Your spirit is justified. Your soul is sanctified. Sanctified. Declared as holy. Then what about your body? Body is actually glorified. So I talked to you three words, justified. Justified, your spirit is justified, made right with God. Sanctified your soul because it is declared as holy. If God say you are holy, means don't doubt, you are holy. And your body is God declared as glorified. Glorified means made eternal by the Spirit of God. That is what our body shall be glorified. Human bodies look all same, but depend on the people's decisions and the right attitude, their bodies also can carry that glorifications. It is declared by the Spirit of God. Our salvation is in Christ covers this total experience, our past and present and future. So God will save us completely from the penalty of the sin. Penalty, no need to pay the penalty because you believe in Christ. Christ paid the penalty of the sin. But as many as received him, to them he gave the right to become the children of the Lord. Yes, This is what Romans chapter 5 verse 8 says. So whoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. John chapter 3 verse 16 says. John chapter 1 verse 12 says. Whoever believes Christ, he will be called as the children of the Lord. So we are the children of the Lord. So that means you are completely saved from the penalty of the sin. No need to pay your penalty of your sin. What's the penalty of sin? Romans 6:23 says the penalty of sin is death. You already paid the equal payment to the death. You paid the life as a death, as the payment of death. Whose life? The Christ life. Where is the Christ life can seen? It is in the life, the Spirit of God, according to 1 John chapter 5, verses 11 to 13. Whoever has the Son, they have the life. That's what it says about it. And also, we are being saved from the power of sin. You know, the power of sin is there. So recently, one girl murdered her child, even last Sunday. So yesterday only they know that the mother is the murderer of her own child. We were shocked. Why this girl killed her own son, 1.5 year old? Very sad. Who read that news, they were disturbed. How can a mother can kill a loving, most loving child? This son knows only the name of mother. Mother is the only source for him, his life. But mother carries him to the seashore and beat him in the stone. And she assured that he died there. She thrown her body into the sea. I was disturbed personally. So when the police questioned her 2 days, she made a complaint against her husband. He only made it. But the police, after this forensic evidence, they have seen that the seawater content was seen in the dress of that mother. They arrested her. So during that time, they got a call from her lover. She is having husband, but at the same time lover. He called her 17 times. Then police was detecting what happened to this. Because this girl was thinking of lust, thinking of the life with her lover instead of loving with her husband. So the power of sin is that much. Power of sin. She forget about the rest of the world. She forget about her father and mother. They were fishermen. They loved that young child, kid, very much. They were screaming. Why should he kill our child? You could have given to us. Why should you do it? Because of only one reason. She has lust. It is mad. The power of sin is too much. The power of sin. That's what the Word of God says. We are being saved from the power of sin. Once you committed your life to Christ, the power of sin, you can see, is very light. It cannot overcome you. But those who are not surrendered to God's will, God's Spirit, God's Word, they'll be like that girl. They'll be running behind the fleshly lust. That killed her own son, only one son. She was a young mother, 22 years old, educated woman, but she murdered her son. Such a cruelty. We can say there is no human can do it, only inhuman can do it. Definitely we can see that one. So beware of these things. If you are saved, if you are accepted Christ, you are saved from the power of sin. Power of the sin. You don't know the power of the sin. It is too heavy for people. Those are weak in flesh. Those are weak in spirit. Those are weak in soul. But it is nothing for the people, those who receive Christ, because the Spirit of God will empower a person to overcome any kinds of threat, any kinds of things. The martyrs of Christ, only one demand the kings and enemies of the gospel demanded before. You confess that Jesus is not God, that's enough for us. They say no. We are in the Spirit. We are one in the Spirit. We are one in the God. We never will reject Christ. Any enemy can try, but nothing is going to happen. You can kill only the body of people. You cannot touch the soul. You cannot touch the spirit of people, because that is belonging to God. Body can be demolished. It is perishable. A perishing person can finish the perishable part of people, but no one can touch the soul and the mind of people. So when we have received Christ, so we need not to pay anything for the penalty of the sin. That's what we Word of God is saying. Penalty, no need to pay the penalty of sin. And we are saved from the power of the sin. And also we shall be saved from the presence of sin. That means the first Psalm also is saying the one of the beautiful narration about the godly people. We should not go in the presence of sin, because we are not supposed to be there, because God never likes to do it. So Psalm number 1, it says we must understand what we are talking about, the power of the God and the power of the Word of God. The psalmist says, King David says about the power of sin. How can we prevent ourselves from the power of the sin? He says about like this, blessed is the man who walk not in the counsel of the ungodly. Not in the counsel of ungodly. It says, nor stand in the path of the sinners. Danger in the path of the sinner. And not sit in the seat of the scornful. They are mockers, mocking people. Don't sit in the mocking people. But he delights in the law of the Lord, and his law he meditates day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, that brings forth the fruit in its seasons, whose leaf also shall not wither, and whatever he does shall prosper. So these are the things that are happening to those who are depending on God. Very clearly the first Psalm is saying about it. But there is ungodly people are there, and something is going to happen to them. That also written there. The ungodly are not so, but are like a chaff which the wind drives away. They are flown away. And therefore the ungodly shall not stand in the judgment, nor the sinners in the congregation of the righteous people. They cannot come and stand before the righteous people. They are weak. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish. The power of the sin, the presence of the sin, the penalty of the sin. God saved us from all such things. In 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verse 44 says, the body that is sown in the death is a natural, puce body. However, it will be raised the spiritually, pneuma body. If there is a natural body, there is also a spiritual body. Two kinds of body, Paul is explaining. Natural body, that is a puce body. That means the body that is sown in the death is a puce body. And it will be raised by a spiritual body. So the natural body is there, spiritual body is there. The natural body never, never accepts the things of God. Because spiritually that cannot do that one. Then it says that it is foolishness things. So Paul is telling us that God has given us a spiritual, spirit-led body. So if we accept Christ, our body become a spirit-led body. We are powerful. We should not worry about the payment of the sin. We should not worry about the penalty of sin. We should not worry about the presence of sin. Lord, the world will fill with a lot of temptations. The list is too much. The medias are filled with a lot of sinful deeds and the sinful, pleasurable things. Even ganja, drugs, many, many things are there. Money is playing a vital role in the lives of people. So, making illegal money is one of the way of many people. So, finally, what will happen? They will end up with jail. They will finish their life. So, all such things people know, but still it is practicing because their body is like that. So, unless they change their body system by accepting the power of the God, they can save their life. That's what the Word of God is talking about. Today, I will tell, I want to point out something like soul sickness. Body sickness is very clear for us. Fever, cancer, and dangerous diseases. All such things are bodily affected diseases. But you know about the soul sickness? Soul sickness also we need to understand. The Luke chapter 4 verse 18, it says about, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. I came here to heal the brokenhearted." I came here to brokenhearted. Brokenhearted means it is a soul related sickness. So, soul based sickness is a common problem of the society because this terminology is used to describe the inner heart of the soul. The soul is paining. The soul pain is increasing. So that is a considerable pain for the human life. That's what Jesus came in Luke chapter 4 verse 18 he says. And many, many people in this world having the scars in their souls. They have a severe pain in their soul. Therefore their body is not tuned properly and not showing any healthy symptoms because their soul scars are still there, that pain. That is bleeding. So we need to be take care of such things. So an inner healing of the soul is a must for everyone's life in this world. So some people are carrying the pains throughout their life. Why should they carry this pain? So they want to make the people that I am wounded. Many girls, many ladies are carrying their wounds. They know Christ died for them, they can heal it, but they don't want to put it before the altar. Because they want to carry their pain always. Because they wanted to see a victimized feeling. That's a psychological defect. These people have a mood disorder. Sometimes they may have overjoy. Sometimes they may have a pleasure mind. But at the same day, within a matter of a few seconds, they will turn into depression. They feel rejections. They felt a lot of heart pains. They wanted to commit, they feel that they want to commit suicide. Some people are committing suicide also because of soul scars carries the intense of pain. So we need to understand this fact is the inner part of man is talking about the John chapter 7 verse 37 and 38. Then our soul is supposed to heal our body. Our soul need to cooperate with the spirit. From where they can get the power? They can get the power from the spirit to heal the body and soul. So we need to understand these things. A healthy soul is always favor for a healthy body. And a healthy soul and a healthy body will lead to a healthy spirit. So these are all interconnected. In 3 John verse 2 says, 3 John verse 2 says about Apostle John says, "Dear friends, I pray that you may prosper and in health, even as your soul prosper, even as your soul prosper." 3 John verse 2 says, John, after seeing many years of his ministry experience, people cannot say very good for their body unless their soul is in trouble. So it is a considerable factor for us. So the soul sickness, we need to consider about our relationship. Our parents are, if our parents are critical, the soul of the children will be going to be hurt very deeply. The soul scars will be always bringing pain to them. Why? Because of the critical parents. Because the parents are sometimes deal with unkind way, unfair way, and unwise verses, and hurting verses, abusing verses, they are using it. So scripture says in Ephesians chapter 6, 4 also, be careful of using these kinds of attitude towards children. But Word of God says that children are to be taught and trained in love, parental relationship. So once we talk about Hitler, he had a bad parental relationship. His father was beating him with a belt, hurting him so much. That day he started to hate his father. He hated his whole relationship. Finally he became a great accuser for many relationships. And he was a reason for the murder of not only one or two people, over 60 lakh of people lost their life because of this man. Nothing is too less, nothing is too great in human life. So parental relationship, we need to take care of it. Father, do not provoke, should not provoke your children. That is abuse. Parental abuse is not addressed by Bible. Discipline your child, but do not provoke it. We need to keep an equilibrium between these two. Discipline is a must. Even a stick, using stick also is essential, but should not provoke. If you want to correct a child, correct it with consciously. Don't use unnecessary things, unnecessary methods. And another is physical damages or abuses. The physical damages, if someone makes towards a child, it will never forget about it. Recently, I noticed that a child wanted to play. The father said, no, you should be sit with me. A father can sit, he can think, but what about this child? Child cannot sit and think because the brain is not developed form. It wants some activity. Child is learning things through activity, through sucking, through touching, through seeing. But this father is not permitting his child to do anything there. And he is thinking that he is disciplining child. I don't agree with that one. So soul pain will start from that moment. That's the psychology also is talking about that aspects. So we want to continue to talk about this matter. May the good God bless you with this word of God. Thank you so much.